Okay, welcome to video lesson for week two. This is 2.2. First thing I'm going to need you to do today, though, is make a correction that Ms. Bones made a mistake in. And it might get a little confusing. So open your syllabus real quick. And we are on week two. And here is your assignments for week two. You should be checking these off as you do them so you can keep up with everything. It says experimenting with line. And it had part one, but that's a little confusing because this video actually had two parts to it. And so it looks like maybe this is part one and this is part two, but actually they're two different videos. All right, this is a different lesson, I mean. This video has two of them, and this video, which you're watching today right now, only has one. So you can just mark out this part on there so that doesn't get confusing. So we have experimenting with line one, which is what you did in the previous two videos. And now we're doing experimenting with line number two. So fix that real quick so that's not confusing. Then we'll move on to the lesson. For today's lesson, you can use your app if you want, okay? We can go to our app here. Now I already took this picture. I had a cup, I positioned it how I wanted to, and I took a picture of it. So here is one picture. We need to find an object that we want to draw. You can use a cup, you can get on a magazine, and if you like a picture, let's say that I like this picture of this butterfly. So I can come on here and I can take a picture of this butterfly, and I can use this, use photo, and then I can push the draw, and then I can change the opaqueness, the opacity of this picture so I can draw it on my paper. Okay, you just have to have something, for instance, to set it on so you can draw underneath it and this will be steady. So you can take any kind of picture out of a magazine. You could, if you had a shed or a barn outside that you really liked, you could also use that. And you can trace the object, kind of get the outline of it. Because what we're going to do today, here is my cup that I used. This is a very simple design, and what we're going to do is we're going to fill it with lines. Now, there's lots of different ways we can do this. You can go very, very simple and just fill it up with lines that reflect the shape of the object. I'm just using some curved lines, really simple here. Let's finish this up. Okay, so I finished this one up, and I just did some really simple curve lines on this is all I used. And you notice I made the lines go with the shape of the cup, so that looks kind of neat. These lines are curved downward, and these lines for this side of the cup are curved in the upward curve. And on the side of the handle, I just took them around like this to show the shape of the handle. So you can do something as simple as this if you want. You can even add some cross hatching to it. So you can do a little bit of cross lines like this if you want to do that as well. You can make them farther apart as they get to the middle and closer to the sides. Okay, something like that. However you want to do this is perfectly fine. Now let's move on to another example that might be a little bit different and a little more colorful. Here we have a simple scenery that I started. I just drew some different color lines here to represent the scenery, and I started the sun already. You notice I did some radiating circular lines that went out and out, and I have orange and yellow ones. So we can go ahead and finish the ground here if you want to try something like this. Let's go and do that now. Okay, so I have finished putting some lines on my landscape here. You notice they are in different directions, and it looks like it's rolling hills. This one looks more elongated because I did lines from left to right. So depending on how you have your lines, it's going to give your scenery a different look. You can use more than straight lines if you want to. You can put patterns in some of these. It's totally up to you. I'm just doing something quick and easy right now. I'm also going to add some trees real quick, so let me do that. Okay, I have added a couple of trees, and you notice the bigger one is closer to the bottom of the page, which means it's closer to me. And this one's smaller because it's closer to the top, so it's further away. And if I'd have put one way back here, it'd have been even smaller than that. And this helps show distance, so this is something you can do as well. Let's move on to another idea. Okay, so here is another one of my little sketches. I drew this with pencil first, just like my other ones, and then I went over it with marker. And this one has an object in it, a barn. And so I'm going to do some straight lines on this and curved lines over here. And we'll see how this one turns out. Okay, so I finished this one and I put my vertical lines here. You notice I did thicker lines for the ground than I did the bushes. And I used a crayon instead of marker for my sky. And I did cross hatching. And I made a little darker over here. I added more lines over here and less lines over here. So this is also an idea of something that you can do as well. Let's move on to my last one, and this one's the hardest one. Okay, so this is a picture of a butterfly I created. Yours can look any way you want. It doesn't have to look like this one. And I just tried to use symmetry. Whatever I did to one side, I did to the other. And I'm just built this up, and this is what it turned into. So I'm going to fill this up with different designs, and let's see how it turns out. Okay, so here is some of the process. I just want to show you I'm not done. I decided to do two of the diagonal lines that come together here and makes a zigzag pattern all the way through. I did the zigzag here, have some straight, thick, and thin lines, have some curls, have lots of different things so far. So I'm going to finish up the rest of this to match, and we'll see how it looks when I'm done. Okay, so this is the finished butterfly, and all of my patterns kind of match on this because the butterfly can be symmetrical. Yours doesn't have to be, but it's probably going to look better if it does. And you can pick anything you want. You can do a bug like this. You can do a cat like this. You can do anything. So pick from some of these examples that we have here. Okay. And remember, you can use your camera app if you want, or you can just freestyle something like this. And you can use color on anything, or you can do it all black and white. You can do marker, you can use pencil, or you can use pen. Doesn't matter. So I can't wait to see what you do. Just fill this up on one of your pages in your sketchbook under your class and home lessons. And make sure you put the date and the title, and you're good to go. I'll see you Tuesday.